Hello, Denis Fyodorov here. Today I want to talk about one of the most important aspects of proper Russian pronunciation, Russian word stress. Problems with stress are very, very common. This either can be this simple beginner's thing when you emphasize the wrong syllable, or this advanced thing when you stress exactly the same as you do in your native language, which causes a pretty strong accent. Or this can be this grammar thing when you find out that the same word can often change its stress. Or when there are these two words written the same, looking the same, but they have completely different meanings because of different stress. There are many common problems and things that can be united under the banner of this stress thing. So, why does the stress causes so many questions and problems? The point is that the stress in Russian is free. Well, there are languages where it is always on the same syllable. Such stress is called fixed. For example, in French, accent is always on the last syllable. But in Russian, it can be on any syllable. A pure liberty, you know, like the founding fathers who wrote the United States Constitution dreamed of liberty and freedom. So Russian stress is about pure ideal freedom. And if a person does not know how to put an accent in a word correctly, one has just to guess where the stress falls. That's why there is no any native speaker of the Russian language in this world who never thought where to put an emphasis inside some word. So let's figure out the important things on this Russian stress. In this video, I'm going to tell you everything you need to know about Russian stress. And let's start with some basic, simple, most important practical things that are mostly about pronunciation, and then proceed with some advanced theoretical materials. You don't need to learn this advanced info, simply watch that stuff, and that's it. So, word stress or accent simply means emphasizing one of the syllables of a word. And by doing that, you automatically de-emphasize all the other parts of the word. So, let's start with the pronunciation, on how to stress. If you look on this stressing thing simply, in the beginning, when you're starting out with Russian, you can stress exactly the same as you would do in English. That's the starting point for a beginner. By doing that as in English, your stressing will not be bad. And under not bad, I mean that people will understand you. When you are a beginner, your first goal in pronunciation is just to be understood. That's what you are trying to achieve, because in the beginning you are very hard to understand. I know you think that you pronounce things very good, but in fact it is not true. And when you stress words exactly the same as in English, from the pronunciation point of view, it sounds pretty okay. I mean, people will understand you. This will not interfere understanding and will be the least of your problems for quite a long time. But English way to stress, of course, does not sound in a native speaker way. And here are the salient points of Russian stressing, which I think will be enough for beginners. First, only vowels can be stressed. It's exactly as in English. I hope this is easy. Second, if there is only one vowel in a word, put stress on it. It's also pretty clear. Short words with one vowel have this single vowel stressed. Third, there can be only one stressed syllable in a word, so no double or triple stress, just one syllable is stressed, others are not stressed. On practice, there can be some rare exceptions for some multi-composite words of which you do not need to know at all. So, in Russian, only one syllable is stressed, so when reading or speaking, you should be clearly emphasizing just one single syllable. Fourth, letter Yo is always stressed. That's clear. However, in real life, people rarely write your and replace it with ye. However, your is still pronounced and it's always stressed. So in practice, this your thing is not of a big help. Fifth, the stress mark in Russian looks like this. It's called acute accent, and I am very much showing this picture to make you not to confuse I краткое and E with an accent mark above it. So accent mark looks this way, and the mark above I краткое looks this way. So please don't confuse those marks. When you are a beginner, you will read only texts and words with stress marks. But in real life, nobody is going to use stress marks in writing, so you'll be on your own. Which leads us to the next point. Six. When learning new words, remember their stressing. It is exactly the same as in English. As English learners do, English has a less random stress mechanism, but on practice, we, English learners, still have to memorize where to stress when learning new words. So make sure you memorize where to put an accent mark. That's the beginner's theory. It is more than enough for beginners, and you do not need to know more. However, when you become a more advanced learner, you would probably want to reduce your accent in order to speak more like a Russian native speaker. And stressing will be one of the problems because you naturally stress emphasize parts of words, not as we Russian native speakers do. So, generally, your stressing looks like too long. In Russian, we would not say this too long, but too long. So compare too long and too long. So English speakers tend to stretch stressed vowels too much compared to Russian speakers. So how to stress properly? Simply speaking, when stressing in Russian, you do two things. Increase the volume of a stressed vowel and make it longer. Usually in Russian, you need to make a stressed vowel about 2 times longer than an unstressed vowel. So all other vowels in the word are short, but stressed vowel is about 2 times longer. But it is still short from an English speaker's point of view, not very long. So you should decrease the length of vowels that are stressed about 2 times compared to how you do it in English for long vowel sounds. You should pronounce them 2 times shorter. Especially it is vivid in tails of words. You tend to stretch endings of words. So that's what you should work at. So the basic mechanism of stressing looks the following. As a beginner, you do things as in English, then you try to pronounce stressed vowels not that long as you tend to do it in English. That's it. Now some advanced theoretical stuff which I think you should be aware of. Just listen to it. No need to remember things, just watch. So let's go through the main characteristics of the Russian word stress. And during this journey, you'll understand Russian stress on a much deeper level than you do right now. First, as said before, stress in Russian is free. Russian word stress is almost as free as the American people. So every syllable in a word, first, second, fifth, can be stressed. So things are random. But here I want to mention that this freedom of Russian accent is still relative because linguists note that stress, first, gravitates to the middle of the word. Second, at the same time, prefers to be placed in the second half of the word. Aspiration to move the stress closer to the center of the word, linguists call the tendency to rhythmic equilibrium. The next characteristic is this. Only one syllable is stressed. But I want to mention that rarely some compound words can have a second stress, like высокоодаренный, highly gifted, or вечно зеленый, evergreen. So those are just multi-composite words written together as one word, like English evergreen. But they logically do consist of two words, so double stressing here can be sometimes applied. But the truth is that you can pronounce these double stress words with one stressed syllable. So one syllable under stress rule always works, even if it doesn't work. The next one thing is mobility. Actually, that's very important, so heads up. Mobility is the ability of a stress to move to another syllable in different conjugation, case, tense, gender, form. For beginners, it even may look like the same word can have different stress. This is water. Это вода. Положи это в воду. Put this into water. As you see, the stress here moved from the last syllable to the first. Or я хожу, ты ходишь. So the stress has moved along with the transformation of the verb. The next example. Сирота, сироты. In singular and plural, we have different stress here. So as you see, a fixed usual stressing is for the weak. In Russian, we do not love to do things the easy way, so Russian stressing is for the true warriors, like you, for the chosen ones. So in Russian, stressing can move or can stay, and you will have to remember stressing for all the words where this stressing moves. However, through practice, your brain will be able to do that automatically. The next thing. All the words of the Russian language, if you say them separately, have a stressed syllable. But in fluent speech, prepositions tend to merge with the subsequent words. It actually happens both in English and Russian, so you say to me instead of to me. For example, in this phrase «пошли со мной» – «come with me». In Russian, we do not say this with me separately, but merge them into «со мной» – «со мной». The same you do in English with me. So in fluent speech, prepositions tend to merge with the word they precede. And when two words merge, they can have only one stressed syllable for two words. Another thing I want to mention in this video is those internationalisms are cognates. These are words that came into Russian from other languages. When learning Russian, you already bring in with you a pretty decent vocabulary of words, which for a while are in your super passive vocabulary part of the brain. And the thing is, Russian does contain pretty a lot of words that have been adopted from other languages, including English. And words brought in from other languages and usually remain there stressed. So when you use or meet such word in Russian that you know is from your language, you'll know where to put an accent mark. Another important moment is that sometimes, rarely, you'll meet some words that are written exactly the same, but the difference between them is only in stress. And they often mean entirely different things. Examples: замок, замок, castle, and lock. These words are written exactly the same but pronounced differently because of different stressed syllables. Or население города, or разные города, population of the city, different cities. This example is trickier because it involves Russian cases, but here you see that the word city in this genitive case is written the same as the same word in a plural form, and the stressing is different. So there are other examples in this category, like мука, мука, я плачу, я плачу, парить, парить, and so on. So that's finally it. I've told everything I wanted. I hope this video was helpful. But since that this video contains pretty a lot of content, I want to say that the most practical stuff you'll need in real life is in the beginning of this video. And I want you to not to forget to implement this advice in the beginning part of the video on how to stress in Russian on practice. So you should decrease the length of stressed vowels about 2 times compared to how you do it in English for long vowel sounds. You should pronounce them 2 times shorter. This advice is the main practical tip of this video. So, thank you for watching and see you.